Franklin artist, Mrs. Scrupa here, and today we are going to learn about line. Now, lines are used by artists all the time. Every time they make a drawing, they use different types of lines. Every time you write your name or a letter, you use lines. So today we're going to talk about different types of lines. And before we get started with our artwork, we're actually going to play a little game. We're gonna play a game called Statue Dance. Now, Statue Dance is kind of like Freeze Dance, but we're gonna think about, as we move our body with the music, different types of lines. So sometimes when we're dancing, we might be standing straight and tall and just wiggling like this, making our body like a straight line. We might be taking our arms and moving them side to side to make it look like diagonal lines. Or we might be kicking our legs up to make bent lines, or really taking our whole body and wiggling to make wiggly lines. Now, the fun part about this game is it's kind of like Freeze Dance, but it's not when the music stops that we freeze, it's when Mrs. Scrupa says, statue. Whatever dance move you're doing, if you're going like this, and I say, statue, you freeze. And when you freeze, you stay nice and still, just like a statue. And then we'll say, all right, dance again. And we'll move to the different types of music that we're going to be playing as we have our statue dance party. Are you ready? You ready to explore different types of lines with me? All right, let's get the music going. All right,
the first dance move we're going to do is the straight line. So if you hold your body like this, make your body nice and tall, and we wiggle back and forth like this, we can take our straight line for a little dance party. You ready to try it? Let's try it with some music.
Ooh, I'm a rebel just like kids now. I've been feeling it since 1966 now. Might be over now.
All right, statue. All right, go back to wiggling. Wiggle your straight line. Well, that was a good one. Let's do a diagonal line. That means we go side to side. So if we take our arms and we go side to side like this, practice it, we can go slow or we can go fast. All right, so we're gonna try that now doing diagonal. You ready to try it? Let me see your diagonals. And statue. All right, go back to dancing. Great diagonals. All right, we can make our diagonals a little bit bigger by going up this high and up that high. Try it that way. Ready? Statue.
You guys are doing great. Now we're gonna do the loop-de-loop line, where if we take our arms and we swing them like this, it looks like we're jumping rope. So practice with me. Good job, you can bounce, you could stay with your feet on the ground and make our arms go like this. You ready to try with some music? Ready?
Can you do it spinning around? What about the other direction? Great job. All right, statue. All right, go back to dancing. Loop-de-loop.
Wow, you guys are doing really great. All right, now we're gonna take our whole body and do a whole body wiggle. So you can go crazy with your arms, you can kick your legs out, you can go down low and jump up, however you would like to do your dance. Are you ready? Because now I'm gonna play my favorite dancing song that really gets the wiggles and the jiggles out and gets us ready for our art project. All right, get your body ready, because here it's time for our last major wiggle wiggle dance party. Let me see those wiggles. Get the arms going. Wiggle down. Wiggle up. Kick your legs. Spin around.
sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet.
Statue! Don't move! Alright, unstatue!
That happened in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. Come on, like the way we rock it. So don't stop.
Statue! Unstatue! Look at those dance moves. That looks great. I like it. Keep it going. Oh, that's a good one. Oh, you're going to have to teach me some of those dance moves. Ready? Statue. All right, let's take a break for a little while because that was a lot of moving around and getting ready for talking a little more about lines that artists may use. So let's take a cool down break and I'm gonna read to you the story, Lines That Wiggle. Lines That Wiggle by Candace Whitman, illustrations by Steve Wilson. Lines that wiggle, lines that bend. Wavy lines from end to end. Lines that tickle and lines that sprout. Bugs have lines that stick right out. Lines to trap, lines to hide. Two lines running side by side. Lines that curve and lines that curl. Underwater lines that swirl. Lines that crisscross, lines that mend. Lines with doggies at the end. Lines that scurry and lines in threes. Lines in leaves that grow on trees. Lines that twist and lines that sway. Lines that swoosh the flies away. Zigzag lines light up the sky. Rainbow lines are way up high. Lines are everywhere you look, so find some lines not in this book. I really like that book, Lines That Wiggle. Let's practice making some lines now. Get out your sketchbooks and find yourself a nice clean page, okay? And on that clean page, we're gonna draw some different types of lines. I'm gonna use crayons today. You can use markers, colored pencils, whatever you have to make colors. So I want you to think about all different kinds of lines. Get your fingers ready, warm them up. Sometimes you need to give them a little wiggle. Pick out your favorite color. And I want you to try drawing some straight lines. So that's from top to bottom, straight. Okay, so just like that. Maybe as you're drawing your straight lines, maybe you want to connect them and make letters. I just made a letter H. Or maybe I want to go again like that and make a tic-tac-toe board. You don't have to do the same kind of thing that Mrs. Scroop is doing, but practice making some straight lines. Maybe some little tiny straight lines. Maybe some really long straight lines. You can get a new color if you'd like, and I want you to try some curved lines. Just like a little rainbow line, just a curved line. I can go that way, I can go bigger this way, I can go bigger this way. Maybe I'll even put a little curved line inside here. I can switch colors, and sometimes we call these curved lines, we make them like they're rainbow lines. So you can make those curved lines for your rainbow lines. Let's try some wiggly lines. Let me get some colors out here. And I want you to practice wiggly your line. Make it wavy. Try different colors, okay? Maybe I'll do a little purple on top of that blue. Different wavy lines, okay?
Let's see, what else could we do? Oh, in our dance, we did a diagonal,
which is like a straight line, but it's not from top to bottom. It goes from side to side like this.
So maybe practice some diagonal lines like that, okay? Let's see, we can do some loop-de-loops, lines like that, then really decorate our paper. I want you friends to create some of your own lines. Be creative and make up your own lines. Maybe you'll do a combination of them, or just have fun designing some lines. So have fun making some lines.
You guys did such a great job today with our dance party, and you really did well playing statue. We're gonna have to do that again. Now, I really loved reading to you the story, Lines That Wiggle, and thinking about all different types of lines that artists use to create artworks. And I loved working with you friends today as we did our line drawing game. I can't wait to see all your creations that you made. Can you hold it up so I can see? Oh, those are good. I love the straight lines, the wavy lines. Some of you even made up your own lines. Great job. You guys are really amazing artists. All right, next week, we're gonna still talk a little bit more about lines and figure out how we can use lines to create some fun artwork with some movement, just like a friend that's on my shirt. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. And until I see you again next week, just remember to keep dancing and have fun.